Everyone, and welcome back to the breakdown. Today we're going to be giving you a complete overview, a complete guide to MCMMO from the perspective of running it on your Minecraft server. Now there's two types of MCMMO tutorials, one that's dedicated towards server admins and one that's dedicated towards players, because there's quite a bit involved when it comes to MCMMO for the player side of things as well. This video we're going to be talking about the admin side. Few weeks I'm going to be doing a video on the player side of MCMMO, so if you're interested in that, be sure to subscribe. However, again, we're going to be going into this plugin here, MCMMO, and what it means to run it on your server, the configuration files, basically everything that you need to know to get MCMMO up and running on your Minecraft server in a great way with configuration and everything. We're going to be covering it all in this video. First and foremost, though, we actually do have MSMR sponsor, which is Apex Minecraft Hosting. You can check it out by the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/Apex. Get an incredible 24-hour DDoS protected Minecraft server for you and your friends. We actually love Apex so much that we host our own server, play.breakdowncraft.com, on them. So again, if you want a great Minecraft server running MCMMO, you can set it up via Apex Minecraft Hosting. Check out Apex the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/Apex. Now, in this video, we're going to be going over the new version of MCMMO, and this is compatible in any version from 1.13.2 all the way up to the current version right now, 1.15.2, and it's going to stay compatible moving forward. Now, MCMMO is a paid plugin. You will need to purchase it. If you go to the link in the description down below, it'll take you to a page where you need to purchase the plugin. I've already purchased it, so I'm not going to go through that whole entire process or anything. Basically, you just click the buy button up here in the top right. You'll also need a Spigot account to view MCMMO here, but here's the download page. Now, MCMMO has quite a bit of awesome features, right? As you can see, I mean, it's 100% compatible with older versions, so if you are converting up, that's not a problem. There is an optional new level scaling for this new MCMO. It has world guard support, it has world blacklisting, new skills, visual improvements, all sorts of stuff, and that's just updates since 2.1. so awesome stuff there. It basically adds the ability to do mining skills and, you know, excavation skills, wood cutting, all of these awesome sword skills, hand combat skills, all sorts of awesome stuff, basically adding MMO features to Minecraft. If you ever like leveled up in RuneScape or, you know, World of Warcraft, something like that, it adds those features to Minecraft. So MCMMO, right? Makes sense, but pretty awesome stuff. Overall, there's not much you need to know here, and here are the more specific features. So as you can see, it's an RPG mod, fully featured party system for MMOs, which is pretty cool. Admins can start XP events, localization, all sorts of stuff there, farming, combat, gathering, animal taming skills, admin chat, party chat, tons of awesome stuff, and then of course world guard support. So tons of awesome stuff there, great plugin. But once you're here, all you want to do is click on the download button here, and it's going to download obviously after you purchased the plugin. Now, we are going to keep the file on the bottom left. For me, you might need to save it in the same screen, but let's go ahead and get this installed on our server. Now, I already have a server here. Let's get ourselves a new background real quick, one that is a little easier to see. All right, there we go. That one's a lot easier to see. We have this MCMMO server here, so we can go ahead and open that up. And then in here, we do have a plugins folder. Now, if you don't have a plugins folder on your server, it's because you don't have a Spigot, Bucket, or Paper Minecraft server. This specific one we're installing on here is a Paper Minecraft server. It's going to work on any Bucket, Spigot, or Paper server, though. If you want to know how to start one of those servers up, check out the eye at the top of your screen, and it'll go through that. We also have it linked in the description down below. But nevertheless, you should have this plugins folder here. Double-click on that, drag and drop MCMMO into it, and then start your server. Pretty simple stuff. Now, at this point, it's going to enable MCMMO, get all the server files set up, do everything it needs to do to get MCMMO set up. Now, this is just running MCMMO. I would normally run this with Vault and, you know, a few other things, World Guard, things like that, but overall, you don't need those. The only plugin you have to have for MCMMO to run is MCMMO. It's not compatible with anything, or it's very compatible with other stuff, but it's not required to be compatible with those. It works without them. So if we double click on this, we will see this MCMMO, as you can see, folder here. If we double click on that, here are all of the config files for MCMMO. There's a lot of these. However, most of these you luckily will not touch. You won't take a look at them whatsoever, right? Don't worry about it, basically. However, I am going to open up a few here, one of which being the advanced .yml. It's going to be more the advanced settings of MCMMO. I'm also going to, let me go ahead and kind of scale this and put it on the screen so we can kind of see it over here. Okay, just get everything reorganized. So we have the advanced.yml and we have the config.yml. So we're going to be opening that up. And we also have some other stuff in here that you might want to take a look at that I'm not necessarily going to be covering. For example, the upgrades.yml, skill ranks, things like that you might want to take a quick look at, but I'm not going to be covering here because most of the time they're not needed. So let's go ahead and make this full screen. And that's very weird. Let's go ahead and do this. And then we can do some zooming or something, make it look a little better so you all can see. Boom. All right. So here's basically everything we have. Now, I would recommend going down through and reading all of this because it's all, as you can see, well documented. Now, one thing I want to mention here is in the very, very top, there is retro mode. Now, basically what retro mode does is MCMMO's default leveling is from 0 to 1000. If you change retro mode to false here, the leveling becomes 0 to 100. Right? So what that does is it takes the first 100 levels and it makes them into one level, right? So it makes leveling up quite a bit more difficult. Whereas MCMMO's, you know, old retro mode made leveling feel more progressive. I personally like the retro better, but that's up to you. If you want more of a traditional MMO experience, the 0 to 100 method is going to be better for you. Now you have message of the day and all sorts of stuff that you can enable or disable. For example, message of the day disabled here, by the way, isn't going to disable it on your entire server. Just disable it for MCMMO. There's all sorts of different stuff that you can go down through here and check out, you know, even like, you know, how the scoreboards work and all sorts of stuff. I'm not going to be going over all of this. However, MCMMO is SQL compatible, excuse me, MySQL compatible, and that is very, very helpful. If you're running a large server, more than 20 players, set up MySQL if you can on MCMMO. It's going to help you so much in saving that data off your server, saving that server space, making things even faster, not having to write to disk, all that, just doing it over the web, basically. It's great, and we actually, every major server that I've ever seen uses it. MySQL to store their my MCMMO data. So hardcore, you can see about death stat loss penalty and vampirism, which is a cool MCMMO feature. Tools, tool mods enabled, basically all these different tools, right, that you can get from MCMMO. Are they enabled? Are they disabled? By default, they are disabled. All sorts of cool stuff, even the party chat here and how all this works and how it's all set up. You can do that there. And then last but not least, you have the MCMMO abilities, how long their cooldown timers are and all of that stuff in order to help you get things set up. I mean, so much stuff here, even like, you know, down to the skills, right? And can you, you know, use acrobats in PvP and all of this stuff, even down here to taming for PvP. Like, can you use, you know, taming in PvP, true or false? Yes or no, right? Just awesome stuff that you can change and rearrange here. Full disclosure, we don't usually change, like for example, we do change some of these, right? Like we disable some stuff in PvP because we just want it to be as fair as possible on our servers. But overall, most of this stuff is never going to be changed in MCMMO, and that is perfectly fine. You never want to change anything in the config or the advanced.yml. I do have the advanced.yml because it is something that you want to kind of take a look at, but again, action bar notifications. Why would you really change those unless you have something displayed in the action bar? General skill stuff, you know? No really reason to change these. This stuff has been very meticulously created and most servers don't change this stuff. If you want to see a server that, you know, if you see servers having changed this stuff, you'll notice it's like they've came in here and doubled this. Max chance might go from 100 to 200, or it might go from 100 to 50. But overall, they're keeping things the same because this stuff is very, very, very well thought out by the developer. So overall, though, these are the two files that are going to be changed the most, the advanced.yml and the config.yml. However, there are other stuff in here that you can't change. For example, like I said, the upgrades can be, you know, changed, and whether or not these upgrades can be finished and all that stuff, that can all be added there. Core skills, you know, different skills in MCMMO. These are all things that you can change and do whatever you want to with them, but overall no changes are really needed in the config. So at this point I'm going to go ahead and open up in game. I'm going to show you all the admin commands that you can use in game, and then we're going to be done. I mean, MCMMO is actually one of those plugins where it's kind of just plug and play, right? You just kind of install it and it runs, and you might set up SQL, you might do some stuff like that, but overall it's going to work perfectly fine for you without anything change wise, right? Even permissions with MCMMO. There are some permissions if you want to like allow players to get tools and things like that in game that you might need to add, but overall, you don't need to add any permissions to MCMMO. You can just deploy it and it works. Now there is a default permission, right? You can give like all the default MCMMO permissions. That's a very good permission to give if you are like me and do like to have control over all the permissions on your server. However, out of the box, MCMMO is just going to work, right? We gave the test, actually. We deployed it on a server. Some people joined it, and it worked. You didn't have to do any permissions or anything, but you can still give them that default permission if you want to. So anyway, that's fine. I already know this. I'm going to go ahead and direct connect really quickly to just the local server here, just local on our account. And once we join in, the funnest thing or the best thing you can do is see if MCMMO is enabled by, you know, mining a block. Now, at first, it's not going to work, right? It's not going to work at first because it needs to level up. Now, actually, excavation's not seeming to be working here, so that's not good, but let's go ahead and check it. So we can do, oh, maybe it is working. I have chat disabled. That's a fail. Let's go ahead and turn my chat to shown. Oh, I accidentally disconnected. This is a fail. Come on, Nick, you can do your MCMMO tutorial better than that. There we go. So we do have that in chat there. And if we go ahead and start mining, it should start working. You have to do this with a shovel. That's very interesting if so. Let's go ahead and give myself a shovel. All right, there we go. Giving myself a shovel, and let's see. There we go. So you actually do have to use a shovel to excavate. I did not know that. See, you learned something about MCMMO. That's why my player tutorial's not been done yet. Give me some slack. But anyway, there we go. So we've now, you know, got that excavation leveled up, and that's kind of proof that it's installed, right? You can kind of see an example of that and how the excavation level is climbing up here at the top and continuing to grow and just more and more and more and more and more, so on and so forth until, boom, you level up. You have woodcutting, you have mining, you have fishing, you have herbalism. So many skills, as a matter of fact. We can do slash MCMMO space help and be able to see all of these different MCMMO, you know, commands here and what they are. Now, one thing I'll give them credit for, they've actually kind of got this all packed pretty nice and neat into one page here. So as you can see, we do have MC stats. So if we do that in game, this is a player facing command, but still, if you do MC stats, you'll be able to see all of the different skills here and what they are. So skills, excavation, we can see we've got two. The rest of these skills we've not touched: fishing, herbalism, mining, woodcutting, archery, axes, swords, taming, unarmed, acrobatics, alchemy, repair, salvage, smelting. Wow, that's a lot. Right, so there's so many skills there, and if someone wants to go in here and max all of these, it's going to take a very, very long time, and people will. We've actually seen it happen. So as you can see, there are the party commands there, and then if we do MCMMO help, we'll be able to, MCMMO help there, we'll be able to see the rest of these. So we've got ourselves MC ability, which is the ability to toggle on the right click activation of an ability. That's going to be your tree feller, that's going to be your super pickaxe, things like that. And then as far as admin commands go, we need to actually op ourselves. So if we op ourselves, I'll be able to get those permissions, and we can run MCMMO help, and I believe see those admin commands. Yes, so here we are. So these special commands are slash skill resets, reset all, right? So skill all, and it's going to reset your skills to zero. MCMMO edit player skill new value, that allows you to change. So if we do that for myself, for example, we can do MMO edit, and then my username, and then the skill we want, which is going to be mining, and then whatever skill we want to make it. So let's set that to 100, and then boom, we are now upgraded there. Mining skill has been modified, and it's actually going to do those kind of one by one there, which is a little annoying, but it is what it is. I actually think it's going through everything we've unlocked. So if we do slash mining in chat, we'll be able to see that our skill here has increased and that we are now mining level 100. See, level 100 there. And you can do this for any skill. You can do slash excavation, slash fishing, and you'll be able to see all of your skills there. Again, though, that is more player facing. Now, last but not least, we do have the slash admin chat. That's going to be only available to people with the permission to use that. And that's going to allow you to talk to other people in like a private staff chat sort of a thing. And then you have MC God, which toggles on a God mode. So pretty simple stuff there. Overall, there's not much you can do even as an admin for MCMMO other than reset skills and things like that. And it's a very simple plugin. I mean, it is what it is. Install MCMMO, run it, and that's it. And I think a lot of people just need permission to do that. There's so much, like, you know, wanting to customize a plugin, and you can go into the language files and customize some of the stuff if you want, but overall there's so much want to customize a plugin, and I get it, but sometimes I think a plugin just needs to be left alone. And MCMMO is one of those where you can do some light configuration and try to make it your own the best you can, but overall leaving it just to its own devices is going to be your best option in most cases. So there's that. That is our admin guide to MCMMO. Nothing too complicated, nothing too crazy. I feel like this one, a lot of people expected a lot more out of it than just, it is what it is. MCMMO doesn't need to be touched much, except maybe, you know, throw a quick permission at it and move on, right? That's it. And you're going to have a lot more results with that. That's what we've done on our servers, and it's worked incredibly well, to be honest. We do go some customization a little bit for like PvP and things, but overall, MCMMO is left to fall. And even big servers, like massive servers, right? I mean, our server has 300 players in peak hours, but massive servers, 3,000 players, do the same thing. They just take MCMMO and they leave it default and let it run its course, and that's what's great about MCMMO. Nevertheless, thank you all so much for watching. I feel like I'm raining at this point. Speaking of our server, come play with us on play.breakdowncraft.com. All of our servers do feature MCMMO, and you will absolutely love it. There's our acrobatics leveling up there. But nevertheless, thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Enjoy MCMMO. My name is Nick, and I am out. Peace.